Hey guys, welcome to my channel. And if you are new here, I am so glad you stopped by. Thank you for taking time out of your day to watch my video. I am Jamie, and today I'm going to be sharing with you some serious major deep cleaning. I'm going to be cleaning some areas that are super dirty, areas that have not been cleaned in a long time. And I even have some things that I have probably never cleaned. So this video is packed full of so much motivation, cleaning motivation, deep cleaning motivation, some satisfying cleaning. And then after I clean, actually the next day, I'm gonna be going and meal prepping, making 3 freezer dump and go meals that are super simple, super healthy meals your family will love. So stick around. We have a lot we're gonna be doing today. First kiss, we were so damn high, we could touch the sky. Drunk on love, drunk on your lips, the feeling I will forever miss. So before I got to the actual deep cleaning, I wanted to pick up my kitchen and the living room. I just don't like it when it's cluttered and messy. So I just kind of wanted to pick things up, put things where they go. It was earlier in the morning and I just wanted to clean everything up, kind of make sure my countertops were clear, empty the dishwasher, put things away, and then I would just feel better about doing the actual deep cleaning. And I'm gonna be having a little chat with all of you later on in this video, so make sure you stick around because I need your opinion on something. It's something that I have an idea for a new video series and I really need your opinion. So make sure you stick around because I need your thoughts, your opinions. So we'll be talking about that later on. All of these baby toys were sitting on the kitchen table because I had disinfected them the day before. We are just getting over the flu in the household, and so the day before I had gathered all of the toys that the babies had been playing with and I disinfected them with some hydrogen peroxide. It's one of my favorite disinfecting cleaners because I know that it kills the flu virus and it's also something that is safe to use on their toys. I definitely don't vacuum our stairs enough, especially considering we have a dog and a cat. So I really spent some time getting into all of the cracks of the stairs. And at first I just went in and used the attachment where I just vacuumed the main part of the stair. And then I went in with a different attachment and got into those, you know, deep corners of each and every stair. Someone like you. If any of you are new here, please say hi in the comment section, introduce yourself, and even if you're not new, say hi to me, let me know how you're doing, how is the new year treating you? I absolutely love chatting with each and every one of you, and I know usually when I'm doing these voiceovers, you know, I'm showing you what I'm doing, I'm telling you, talking more about cleaning, but I also like using these voiceovers to kind of just chat with you, like we're two friends hanging out, talking. So how are you guys doing here in the new year? How is it treating you? Besides getting sick with the flu in our household, things have been going pretty well. We were super busy in the fall, and then obviously the holidays is always so busy. So things kind of come to a screeching halt in January, which I kind of love and welcome. It's just nice to be able to take a breather and kind of be lazy at home. So things are going pretty well, but I want to know from you. Let me know how things are going. Again, make sure you're sticking around because I need your opinion and your input on a new video series as well as those freezer meals. So if you need some meal inspiration for your family, you're definitely going to want to watch that part of the video. Yeah. The next deep cleaning test I moved on to was deep cleaning my blinds. And you guys have seen me do this recently, but I will tell you, there was one set of blinds that I had not cleaned in a long, long time. I had kind of forgotten about them and they were so, so dirty and gross. So I will get to that in a minute. But first I wanted to get to the blinds in my living room and my front room, and I just used End Dust. So I went in, cleaned my blinds, and then I was going to clean my windows, at least from the inside. I cannot wait to clean the outside of my windows, but it's still super cold here in Ohio. I am itching to get out there and really clean the windows. I guess I'll have to wait until spring or it gets a little bit warmer. So stay tuned for some spring cleaning videos because I will be outside scrubbing those windows. Make sure you're subscribed and have the notification bell turned on because I have some really, really fun organizing and decluttering projects coming up here on my channel. I've been planning them out, ordering things, going shopping, so make sure you're subscribed because we have a lot of things I want to tackle. And to be honest, I'm really, really excited about it. And I know that maybe sounds kind of embarrassing, but decluttering and organizing truly makes me happy. So stay tuned. So the blinds above my kitchen sink were super, super dirty. The camera doesn't really even show all of the dirt that was on there. So it took me some time to get in here and really clean my blinds. It took way longer than cleaning the other blinds in the house just because they were way dirty. I guess, oops, I had let them go a little bit too long. The next thing I wanted to do was clean and disinfect our garbage cans. So I had a garbage can from our kitchen, and then there was one in the bathroom that's off of our kitchen. And this is something that I think a lot of us forget to do. You know, when you think about what goes in here, it's kind of gross when you think about it. So I wanted to go in here and I sprayed it down with my DIY cleaner of 1/4 cup of rubbing alcohol, a teaspoon of Dawn dish soap, and the rest water in the spray bottle. So I just kind of sprayed it. I let it sit for a little bit to disinfect, and then I went in, wiped it all down. Then I even went in a second time with some disinfecting spray from Seventh Generation. So I just kind of wanted to give it a really, really good cleaning. So you all have seen me deep clean my sink a million times. And even though I was focusing on other deep cleaning tasks today, I couldn't pass up scrubbing out my sink just because I love a clean sink. And I just feel so much better when my sink is really clean. And so I do that every single day, and I just knew I probably wouldn't get a chance to do it later on. So while I was in this cleaning mode, I went in and really scrubbed out my sink. So before we get started, a lot of deep cleaning as well as some freezer meals. I'm gonna be meal prepping 3 meals to pop in the freezer so we can take them out during a busy weeknight and we'll have a healthy, yummy meal for everyone. So that's my plan. I wanna talk to you guys. So moving forward with some of the videos here on my channel, you know, I'm trying to figure out what videos I like watching. I'm trying to figure out what videos I like making, what videos you guys want to see. And I kind of want to start something new. So as a mom, and I know that a lot of you guys, even if you're not a mom, you have a to-do list, right? And so I was trying to think of maybe a video where it would be you guys kind of, so it'd be kind of you guys joining me for the day. So it'd be kind of like a vlog, but it would be more so me tackling my to-do list, if that makes sense. So of course cleaning would be in it because cleaning is a part of my daily life. But it could be literally what's ever on my to-do list. And of course, if it's a day, and of course the girls would be in it. So I'd be bringing you along for my day, but we'd be tackling the to-do list throughout the day. You know, cleaning, meal prepping, meal planning, maybe grocery shopping, running errands, taking care of the girls, all of that. So I'm kind of thinking that might be something fun that I can kind of merge all of the cleaning and organizing part of my channel with more of the family life and vlog type, if that makes sense. So if this is something you guys would, you want to see, you're interested in, let me know down below. And also, like, I was trying to think of a catchy title for it, so let me know what you think. Something with like a to-do list, tackling a to-do list. I know there's a lot of, specifically with Tiffany Beeston, the get it all done, something like along those lines. So if you can think of anything creative or catchy for a title, and I will do a lot of those if you guys are interested. So let me know down below if it's something you guys want to see. I just find those videos super motivating, and there's just nothing better than completing your to-do list, or at least getting a big chunk of it done. And I just think it would be fun because you guys would be joining me throughout the day and getting to see more of the girls, but also we would be productive and hopefully the video would be motivating as well.
You say all the right things when I'm hurting. You always pick me up when I am down. It's like you have a spark that leaves me burning. You just have your ways to get me high. You make all my dreams come true. It feels right when I'm around you. We could break up and then make up. I always come back to you. You move me in a way never thought anyone could. You get me high.
So many of you comment on my dog Reese and how, I guess, what she does while I clean. She's usually my little buddy, my little partner while I'm cleaning. She just follows me around the house while I clean. She is such a good dog. She is a half yellow lab, half golden retriever, and all of the girls love her.
You touch me in a way that makes me shiver. Sometimes I can't believe that you are mine.
So for the most part, my house was pretty clean. I had knocked out a big chunk of my deep cleaning tasks. I did not finish everything. You know, sometimes you're able to finish that list and other times you're not, but hey, that's real life. That's mom life. You can't always devote all of this time to cleaning. So I was not able to get to deep cleaning my oven. So I will just be doing that here soon. So I guess if you need some oven cleaning inspiration, stay tuned. I will be tackling that. Maybe in an upcoming video. Now Sunday, and I'm gonna do some meal prep. And I thought, a lot of you guys say that you like seeing what meals we make and what we meal prep for the week. And it's just easy when we plan meals ahead and we have them ready to go, either to throw in the Instant Pot, throw in the crock pot in the morning or at lunchtime, or something that we can just throw in the oven. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today. I'm gonna be meal prepping three yummy meals that some of them we've tried before, some of them we haven't. So hope you guys enjoy them, and I hope it's something you guys will try as well. And Miss Addison wanted to say hi to you. Can you say hi? Can you say hi? It's just one of those lazy Sundays where we are in our jammies, or babies are in their jammies. So we are gonna get to meal prepping so we can be ready for the week.
Hi.
Just want to stay.
so you guys can probably see, but poor Addison still has some chapped lips, kind of the skin below her nose, above her upper lip. It's just chapped from being sick with the flu and having a constant running nose and just wiping it. Poor girl, but you can tell she's doing a lot better, which is good, but she had a rough go around with the flu, but I'm just glad she's finally feeling better. So my first meal was a crock pot chicken fajitas. This one is so easy to prepare, and I was just going to throw it in a freezer bag, and then all you have to literally do is dump it in the crock pot for an easy, healthy meal whenever you want to eat it. So I chopped up some peppers and some onions, and then I made a marinade of lime juice, olive oil, and some seasonings, and I will have the full recipe, the website where I got the recipe from, as well as the other recipes that I'm talking about. It will all be linked down below in the description. And then I just threw it in a freezer bag, and there you have it. Everything super easy. It's a perfect freezer meal, just healthy and simple. The next meal was an Instant Pot Fiesta Chicken. I feel like there's so many variations of this recipe out there for the crock pot or the Instant Pot, and it's always one of my favorites. I feel like all of these ingredients, you can't go wrong. You can just kind of throw them all together and it always tastes good. But all I had to do was chop up one red pepper and then add in a bunch of cans. So literally dumping a bunch of cans into a bag, some taco seasoning, put it in a freezer bag, literally so easy. And then you can just open up the bag, dump it in the Instant Pot. It does call for rice, but you can add that later on when you're actually making the meal. The last meal was chicken pesto tortellini bake. This one was incredibly simple. And I know I keep saying that word over and over with these recipes, but you know that I hate to cook, so things have to be simple or I will feel overwhelmed and I won't do it. So, all simple meals. But for this one, I just took some rotisserie chicken, and you don't even have to add chicken, but we wanted the added protein. So I had some already shredded rotisserie chicken from Costco in my freezer. You can buy literally just the rotisserie chicken. So we did that. We had that in the freezer. So I just pieced that up, and then I poured in some tortellini, two jars of Alfredo sauce, some mozzarella cheese, and some pesto sauce. Then you just mix it all together and literally throw it in a baking dish where you can freeze it. And then whenever you're ready to bake it, you just pop it in the oven for 30 minutes. Now, if I wasn't going to be making this the next day, which I was going to, then I would put it in one of those foil pans, if that makes sense, you know, like those throwaway pans, because then it would be easier to put in the actual freezer. They're smaller, easier to put in there, but I knew I'd be making it the next day, so I just put it in a regular baking dish. And then I made sure I labeled everything with what it was and the date. And there you have it. Three super easy meals that took me maybe an hour to meal prep. But that's going to be it for today's video. Let me know if you liked it by giving me a thumbs up. Let me know what you think about that to-do list video series. Follow me on Instagram. I have the link for that in the description. Make sure you're subscribed, and I will see you next time.